So, like, what types of questions were asked in the interview?
So, like I said, they ask mainly from two regions. They can ask you from the detailed application form, the DAF. They can ask you about your hobbies, about your hometown, about if your mom and dad is working in such a place, about that institution. So these kind of questions they can ask. And along with that, they can ask some current affair oriented questions. Like for me, they asked about the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, the RCEP. They asked about defections. They asked about forest cover, forest fires. Because that is also from my career. I'm in the Indian Forest Service now. So depending on this, in the interview, it is not very difficult to predict questions, except the current affair, a few questions. That whatever questions that can arise from the DAF, that is very predictable. So you'll be fluent with that. And whatever current affairs you have, you make sure you read up. And it's not a bad idea to revise your mains notes once before you go to the interview, because many questions of current affairs will be overlapping with the mains. So revising GS2, GS3 notes is also helpful, I felt.
I think mostly the questions were on my DAF and, you know, my hobbies and my optional. Okay. And also my and also from my studies. For example, I got a question regarding, because I did my master's from IIT Kharagpur, which spoke about, things like RF and microwave engineering. So those questions regarding spectrum allocations. And I worked in Germany. So, you know, I got questions on Hitler and, you know, questions on concentration camps. And because I was interested in music and learning languages, I got questions on, those fronts. Because my option was history, they asked me what are the difference between left-wing history, right-wing history, who's your favorite historian, what is the favorite portion of history. So all those things. And there were, you know, follow-up questions to that thing. And because I lived in Bengal, there were questions regarding, you know, in Calcutta and, you know, all that thing. Basically, it's like things which are surrounding you. But then there were also some questions regarding current, which was burning in the sense. Some current affairs, obviously, there some philosophical questions. What's wrong with judiciary? So then I said, judiciary, obviously, you know, some issues are there. But then I passed the buck saying that, you know, I just said whatever honestly I felt. So they asked me about what's the problem with judiciary. I said, you know, yeah, judiciary is very assertive, but much of the problem can also be traced to executors. Then they were very intrigued. Can you give an example? I said, you know, I will give you three examples. I can give many examples. So I was able to add on to that because I have this conviction that, okay, our executor is not doing the way how it should do. And that is why judiciary is wielding a lot of power. So I was able to reflect on those things very clearly. So, you know, that's such kind of questions which could be taken to a more structural issue of the Indian polity. Let me say that thing. So, okay. Now those things were there. Yeah, pretty much that's it.
Interview, the chairperson started asking questions directly from the DAF. Why I quit my corporate job, all those things. And secondly, as I said, I gave IFS as my first option. So there were a lot of questions asked from the international relations. Also, that was the day when Mr. Trump was visiting India. So I got a lot of questions from IR. So predominantly 50% of the questions were from international relationship, a few questions from DAF, and from DAF, for example, why I took social justice subject on my hobby. They asked me questions about why I start watching football, all those things. Yeah.
Okay.
And they asked some few facts which I didn't know. So it is always better you say no. There is no harm in saying no.